Alright, Duke of the Bump here. Let's finish Sonic Megamix. I mean, we're probably not going to finish it in this video, but I will definitely finish it in this recording session, most likely. Unless it ends up being like 1,000,000% harder than the rest of the game or something. So yeah, the last like 5 videos or so were all recorded as part of the same session. I usually don't like recording, you know, multiple videos, but with my current setup, it's just easier that way to record. Whoa, what happened to the spring? To record like 5 videos at once, and then, you know, I can just edit them later. But, I have some good news. I am getting a new computer, and it'll be arriving on Wednesday. And I'm taking 2 days off work, Wednesday and Thursday, you know, just for the occasion, so I can, you know, get everything set up and, you know, have fun playing with my new toy before I have to go back to work. So, yeah, it should be pretty awesome. It's, I went with one of those, build-to-order websites. It's called CyberPower, which is a really dumb name for a site like that, but I hear they have a pretty good reputation and they do pretty good work. And the reason I went with that is because, well, the last time I got a new computer, I tried to build my own. I figured that was going to be a bottomless pit, but I thought it was worth a look anyway. But yeah, the last time I tried to build my own computer, it died in about, you know, 6 months or so, if even that. So I'm going with, you know, a trustworthy or semi-trustworthy manufacturer slash, I don't know what you would call them. I mean, they're a retailer mostly, but you know, they'll build the computer to your specifications. And I ended up going with a pretty beastly system. It's not top of the line or anything. You know, for the computer nerds out there, I ended up going with an Intel i5 quad-core 2.66 gigahertz processor, I think, and a Radeon, I think it was 8550 or something like that. I don't know. I went to the serious hardware software crap section of Something Awful, and they had like a guide to building the most cost-efficient, you know, basically the best computer you can get for the money at this point in time, and I just went with their guidelines when I was choosing my parts. So yeah, has 4 gigs of RAM, 500 gig hard drive, of course, and you know, nothing fancy. It has a you know, it has a standard DVD burner, no Blu-ray or anything, you know, just basically what I need. But it'll make editing videos, you know, a whole lot easier, and recording, because I can just use the old, you know, the recording method I'm used to, instead of this crap where it's like, you know, half the time it takes me 3 days to figure out how to edit a video without it fucking up somehow. So yeah, I should be able to start posting videos more frequently than this, you know, 2 to 3 video per week schedule I have been on, which, you know, I guess it's still better than nothing, but I'd like to update with a little bit more frequency. I hate ball hogs. Worst enemy in the game, I'm calling it. Well, except for those spiky things. That looks like a trap. Do I dare try? Okay, it's a trap. And all this down there is speed shoes, so I'm not going to bother. But yeah, those green spiky things in the Starlight Zone where, you know, the other ones throw their spikes at you so you can hit them, but not the green ones. They're just totally unhittable. Wow, that was a narrow escape, but I ended up getting fucked anyway. Oh, somebody changed the topic in the chat. Let's see. Jay is a cutie patootie. Rob is online. Fuck Villanova, you were in my final four. Eat my sack. I think that has something to do with basketball. I'm not really sure. Yeah, I'm still hanging out in the chat room. and Perps and Jay streams, even though I don't think Jay is streaming right now. I'm gonna post like a formal announcement video, but like the weekend after next, the weekend of like April 4th or something, I think it is, I'm probably gonna be participating in Perpetual Ascent's donation stream. If he reached a certain amount of donations, which he has, then we were going to play Worms Armageddon for the 360 on the stream. Although now that I have, or I want to have a good computer at that point, so maybe we can just play the PC version. But yeah, if you don't normally watch streams, then you should definitely check that one out. Because, you know, I'm going to be there, and I'm awesome. But Perpetual Sense and Jay streams, you know, they're awesome in general. But, you know, since I want to be there, you know, obviously that's just going to make them like 800% more awesome. So, yeah, it should be a good time had by all. And like I said, I'll post a formal announcement on YouTube at some point for the people who don't watch my normal videos, which I don't know why you wouldn't, but. So yeah, so far this doesn't appear to be that much more difficult than any of the other levels. I've just been flying through this game. Uh-oh. It's time for Robotnik to do something cheap. Yep, same thing he does in Sonic 1. He steps on the button and I fall to my doom. Only it's not my doom. It's Metallic Base Zone Act 3. And it looks like this one is going to be underwater as well. Now in Sonic 1, you can make this level uber easy just by outrunning this thing. And okay, so yeah, they did away with that. Yeah, I guess they're not going to make it easy on me this time. That's kind of a shame. But you know, I've been blazing through this game otherwise, so it'll be nice to have something of a challenge, which I expect this will be. Since, you know, it's both the Metallic Base Zone and underwater. Wow, that was cool. I like ring dashed my way through the little spiky fortification thing. Whoa, I'm standing on the spike. I better stop for some air. You know, I might beat the game in this video. I hadn't counted on that happening, but it is a possibility. I mean, so far, you know, these levels haven't been, you know, obscenely hard or anything. But the last boss, I hope they at least do something spectacular with the final boss. Damn, I didn't want to do that. But I have to say, I'm impressed with this hack overall. I mean, it has its problems with, you know, glitches and. You know, it would be nice if it was a little more different from Sonic 1 than it is. Interesting. But, I mean, it's pretty good. I mean, I figure that hacking Sonic 1 is probably harder than hacking, you know, Super Mario World or something. You know, I want to try something. Maybe if I didn't actually rush into the spikes, well, doesn't look like, yeah, nothing but spikes down there. Okay. I wanted to see if maybe I could dash to a safer position and there was actually something down there, but no. It's kind of funny that it actually gives you that option, even though there's no way to survive if you do that. So yeah, new computer, I'm excited. It should open up a slightly larger window of games that I could put. Well, it didn't work that time. Of games that I can potentially LP. I figure this will take two videos, so my next LP, whatever it is, you know, I probably won't even start that until I have my new computer, because I have a great idea for what game I want to do next, and I mean, it might be kind of tough. The game I'm thinking of came out in the early 2000s, so I'm not sure how well it'll run on XP. I mean, I've run it on XP before, but if I recall, I had issues with it. So, yeah, we'll see. But if it works, it should be, you know, totally awesome. I searched YouTube to see if anybody's LP'd it yet, and there's only one real LP of the game, and it's in German, so, you know, I'd be bringing something new to the English-speaking audience, unlike, you know, Sonic Megamix, which at least 20 people have LP'd by this point, and like 10 of them have commented on my videos. And we're coming right up about on the 11-minute mark, so I'm going ahead and pause it here and tune in next time for the conclusion of Let's Play Sonic Megamix. I'm Duke of the Bump. Later.